Good day. For today's video, we are going to discuss Quarter 2. Physical Education, Grade 8. Nature and Background of Sport, Volleyball. Objectives. At the end of this lesson, you should able to. Number 1. Identify the nature and background of volleyball, and Number 2. Appreciate it as sport through executing the skills involves in it. Nature and background of volleyball. The director of physical education in Young Men's Christian Association in Holyoke, Massachusetts, USA, named William G. Morgan created the sport, volleyball, on 1895. The elements of basketball, tennis, baseball, and handball are combined together to create this sport. William named it as Mintonette, until a professor from Springfield College in Massachusetts noticed the volleying nature of the game, and proposed the volleyball as a name of the sport. The Fédération Internationale de Volleyball, FIVB, was founded in 1947, and they govern the all forms of volleyball on a global level. Facilities and equipment. Number 1. Court dimension. The game is played on a volleyball court 18 meters, 59 feet long, and 9 meters, 29.5 feet wide, divided into two 9 meters times 9 meters halves by a 1 meter, 40 inch wide net, placed so that the top of the net is 2.43 meters, 7 feet 11 and 5/8 inches, above the center of the court for men's competition, and 2.24 meters, 7 feet 4 and 1/8 inches, for women's competition. These heights are varied for veterans and junior competitions. Number 2. The net. It is above the center line. For the women completion, it is 7 feet and 4 inches above the ground, and 8 feet above for men. Number 3. Pole. It is set 36 feet apart, and 3 feet further out from the sidelines. Number 4. Antenna. It is attached to the net at each end. The purpose of the antenna is to give the referee and players an aid to judge if the ball is in play or out of bound. It is often red and white in color. The patterns consist of a large red part followed by a large white part repeatedly. Number 5. Ceiling height. Volleyball courts should be free of any obstruction caused by any objects within a height of 23 feet above the playing space. That's why any basketball rims or low-hanging banners, posters or objects hanging over an indoor court are removed, or are moved from anywhere above the playing area before the start of an official competition. 6. Ball. It is spherical ball made from leather or synthetic leather with a circumference of 25.6 inches to 26.4, and weight of 9.2 to 9.9 ounces. Volleyball rules. The game is played by two teams with six players each. To gain score, the player should hit the ball using the hands over the net into the opponent's court in such a manner that the opponent is unable to return the ball. The match can last for more than 1 hour to 1 hour and 30 minutes, but the clock is not a factor. The game continues until one team has won 3 games. The first 4 sets are played to 25 points, but when the match goes to a 5th set, this game is only played to 15 points. To win a set, a team should win by 2 points. The first team to win the 3 games wins the match. Number 1. The official court measurement must be 18 meters by 9 meters. Number 2. To start the game, the server may serve from anywhere behind the end line, either overarm or underarm, into the opposing team's side of the court. Number 3. The opponent team is permitted a maximum of 3 touches before sending the ball back over the net. Number 4. The player is not allowed to touch twice the ball in a row, but they are allowed to hit the ball on the 1st and 3rd contact. Number 5. The ball must be hit, not caught. Number 6. The serving team receives a point if the opponent fails to return the ball over the net, hit the ball out of bound or commit a violation. Number 7. When the team wins the point, then they go to serve. Number 8. Every time a team wins the serve from the other team, the players rotate their position on court clockwise so that everyone gets a chance to serve. Basic skills in playing volleyball. Serving.
Letter A, underhand service. To serve, the player holds the ball in one hand. Swing the right arm backward, transfer weight to the front foot, and strikes the ball from the bottom with a fist.
Letter B, overhand service. To serve the ball, the player should toss the ball above the head and hit it by extending the arm. Letter C, sidearm service. To serve, the player should draw the right arm from the back and then swing it forward to hit the ball. The ball may be hit directly or it may toss into the air a few inches high. Hitting the must follows through parallel to floor. Letter D, passing. The most important skill in playing volleyball. If the player can't pass the ball after the serve, then the team can't make a point. How to pass the ball. Number 1. For the ready position, the players needs to bend their knees. Number 2. The forefingers perpendicular and the thumb are parallel to each other. Number 3. The player must straighten their arms to hit the ball either by arms or wrist. Letter E, digging. It is defensive maneuver that the player save the team from the attack or spike of the offensive team. It is almost the same with pass, but in dig the player use different part of their body parts such as foot, hands, arms, and sometimes legs just to save the ball. You can practice passing and digging using these drills. Letter F, setting. It is tactical skill that the player receive the ball and direct it to the player who can spike it in the opponent's court. How to set the ball. The player who will receive the ball needs to make sure that their hands fit in the shape of the ball to toss above the head through pushing the ball and extending their arms. Letter G, spiking. It is an act of slamming the ball in downward motion across the net to the opponent's court. How to spike the ball. Step the right foot followed by the left foot. Then, jump and hit the ball. Letter H, blocking. It is an action taken by the player to stand or jump in the front of the net to stop the opponent's attack. How to block the ball. Number 1. For the ready position, the player should bend their knees and elbow, and the arms are raised in the front of the face. Number 2. The blocker must be alert and prepared to run left or right when the setter set the to the spiker. Number 3. The blocker should jump straight with extended arms and spread fingers to successfully alter the opponent's attack. I hope you learned something in our lesson for today. See you again in our next video. Thank you for listening.